I mean, that texture is crazy. It's almost better than pork in a way.
It's not what you think it is.
This, in a variety of different ways, this is just so much more sustainable and healthy than what we have today.
Hi, my name is Douglas Williams. I'm the chef and owner of Meter Restaurants. It's no secret that our planet is changing, and with it, what we eat. There is no waiting. We can taste it, we can sense it, we can smell it, we can talk about it, and we can listen to each other about it. And that starts in the kitchen. We're gonna be making something that's very near and dear to my heart, which is a pork cheese sandwich. I'm in the kitchen today with the Museum of Science to ask, what's on tomorrow's menu? Christophe Chantre is one of the co-founders of Tender Food, a food and material science technology company. They're making some plant-based meat in a whole new way. Christophe joins me in the kitchen today to talk about the future of plant-based meat and why it could end up on tomorrow's menu. You know, it's so cool to see something that I know, I know the texture, I know the flavor, I know the seasoning, but it's not what you think it is. What is it?
This is a pulled pork that's made just from plant ingredients.
Incredible. Directly. How is it made? What's it about?
What we do is we take a couple different plant proteins or ingredients. So okay. Barley protein, oat fiber, pea. And then we'll take those, we'll mix them into water. And that's going to form what kind of looks like a protein shake, essentially.
Okay.
And then we're going to feed that into a cotton candy machine. So in the same way that, you know, in a cotton candy machine, you're going to take sugar, you're going to melt it into some sort of like spinning reservoir and then spin out a fiber. That's essentially what we're doing, but with these plant proteins, and that we can then assemble into anything from a chicken breast to pulled pork. This is a machine, a technology that we invented in labs at Harvard around 10 years ago and that we've been developing ever since, essentially.
Okay. Yeah. Oh my goodness, that's so cool.
The goal is really essentially to be a meat company, you know, and be able to provide that alternative to animal meat. So essentially providing that kind of raw product so that you can then really kind of cook with whatever you want. Yeah.
Okay, and let your expression go through it. That's very cool. Well, should we start to do a few things?
Yeah, let's do it. We're doing all of this because of, you know, the climate implications of producing meat. And we need to find alternatives quickly.
The incentive is high.
Yeah, exactly. Food just generally is just such an enormous industry. You know, over 2/3 of all agricultural land on our planet is used to grow crops to feed animals. What happens if 2/3 of the agricultural land on our planet become free for something else?
How was your first interaction with plant-based meat?
I think alternatives to meat is not something that's new. You know, tofu has existed for thousands of years, and you know, society and culture has been trying to develop ways of making alternatives to meat or kind of other ways of making protein. But I'd say this is really these cotton candy machines that we invented and that we've been scaling is really the one that we've seen as being the best for this application.
It's also pretty awesome that you can say you invented a cotton candy machine. I just throw that out there. All right, so I'm gonna bring this on over here. Add a little bit of that, a good amount of meat, maybe one full hoagie's worth, whatever that is. There you go. How has the public perception shifted?
It's been really exciting to see that there's a ton of interest. You know, this is such a new industry, essentially. You know, it's only 10 years old. And so I think what's been really exciting over the last 5 years is more and more people are becoming interested by these types of offerings.
Ah, there we go. Look at that caramelization.
The cow is an end product that we can't really change.
Absolutely.
This we're making from the ground up, you know, and so can we
so you
really
have some
design.
Variability to do things.
We can really
and
design
creative.
What we want. That's what's really exciting, what I think, you know, consumers are little by little recognizing. Right now we're starting to work with a lot more restaurants, and a vast majority of the restaurants that we work with, they don't have any plant-based meat on their menu. Because most of the products, I think, for them were maybe just still kind of not good enough and maybe too expensive.
Bring that over here if you don't mind. Oh. Did you ever grow up with subs or any sort of thing like that? What was your version of? And you can be very honest. You
know. No, so I grew up in Switzerland. Barbecue is not really, or like kind of subs and stuff like that, is not really something that I grew up with. I
well, mean, you
really
only good. Grew up with the best chocolate in the world. It's okay. It's all.
Yeah. So is this close to like a version of a classic sub that you would
it
do?
Is, or? It is. It is. Cheese sauce just to create cheesiness. Magic touch. Onions and peppers. As is traditional, texture, flavor, spice. We used to also put potato chips in our subs.
Okay.
And things like that. So, and this is like a small in Atlantic City where I'm from.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it gets really ridiculous. But then you just take it and just cut it. And there you go. You want to do one quick bite?
Yeah, let's
see. Is that all right with you?
Okay, I'm going to try to get a little bit of everything.
Yeah. I mean, that texture is crazy. It's almost better than pork in a way. A, because you don't feel as bad, but also because it's actually sensational.
It's really good.
It's really good.
It takes on sauce nicely. No,
it behaves
really good.
In a very similar manner, and it just, I can't really get over it. I think I am a bit shocked that I don't see this around more. I think the public perception may be a little askew. Maybe it's going to be our job to correct it. I think maybe we can't depend on just solely the public to do that.
That's why we're working with more and more chefs, I think, is because you are the trendsetters, right? You are the ones that are bringing all these kind of new innovations, these new products to end consumers. That's often where people try new things is in restaurants before they buy it at the grocery store.
And as far as like sustainability, how do you see this helping?
The bottom line is, meat production is extremely, you know, polluting and destructive. And what we're able to do here is make a product that produces at least 90% less carbon emissions, that uses 90% less water. And so this, in a variety of different ways, this is just so much more sustainable and healthy than what we have today. Today, plant-based meat is roughly 1% of the entire meat market. Going after that 99% is really what we're fighting for. All the alternative meat companies that exist, whether it's plant-based, fermentation-based, cell-based, you know, we're all working in that direction to try and, you know, remove as many animals as possible from our food system.
Yeah, man, that's good, man. Tastes like a hoagie to me.